curses! Now I'll never join the party!" complained Queen Bee. But its day was getting worse and worse. The flatbed from Skarloey's coupling snapped, and he rolled down the hill towards the siding. "Help! I can't stop!" shouted Queen Bee, but it was too late. They crashed into the buffers, and moss and leaves fell from the cliff.
"Ouch! Help!" he gasped weakly.
Luckily, no one was hurt, but Mr. Percival was very cross.
"Queen Bee, what you've done was very dangerous. What were you thinking?" asked Mr. Percival sternly.
Queen Bee felt very silly.
"I'm sorry, sir. I only wanted to find a way so that I could join the party too."
"Well, that's very dangerous. The mountains are no place for a boat. You could fall off at any place if you go up there."
"I appreciate you giving it to me straight," said Queen Bee sadly. "I'm a useless boat."
Then Skarloey had an idea to cheer Queen Bee up.
"I know a shortcut that will take him to Coldyfell, sir, and it doesn't involve going up the mountains."
"What shortcut?" asked Mr. Percival. Because he only worked on Sodor for 5 years, he doesn't know about Renaissance Skarloey's shortcut. Skarloey puffed up and told Mr. Percival all about the old track he used to take before Menaeus arrived. "It's very smooth and it's set up in the countryside, but tracks are strong enough to hold Queen Bee if it's safe enough." Mr. Percival thought inviting Queen Bee to the party was a very good idea, but he thought taking Queen Bee along Skarloey's shortcut was the most safest way to transfer him to Coldyfell.
"Okay, Queen Bee, you can come to the party."
"Yes, thank you, sir. And thank you for helping me, Skarloey," he said. "You're a very good friend to help me."
So Skarloey coupled up to Queen Bee. Queen Bee was very heavy. Skarloey puffed with all his might. His pistons creaked and his wheels screeched, and soon they were on their way. Skarloey didn't give up puffing. Coldyfell, everything was ready for the party. The dancers were about to perform, the audience was ready, and a barbecue was set up, and Rusty and Menaeus were waiting. But Skarloey didn't arrive. Rusty was surprised.
"Where's Skarloey? It's not like him to miss the party," he said.
"Don't worry," said Menaeus. "I'm sure he'll be here soon." Suddenly, there was the sound of an engine's whistle and the pistons pumping. As Skarloey soon chuffed up with Queen Bee. The two engines were surprised.
"Sorry I'm late," he gasped. "I had to pick up a guest of honour."
"We could see that," said Rusty.
"How did you manage to get him up here?"
Skarloey told the engines all about the shortcut he remembered. Menaeus thought of it too.
"I wish I'd thought of that," he sighed.
"Well done, Skarloey. You're a very brave, strong, and useful engine. Now let's get this party started." Soon, everyone had a wonderful time. They danced, they enjoyed the food, and Queen Bee was having a wonderful time.
"This is a great party. Thank you, Skarloey."
Skarloey was tired, but delighted. And they all agreed that this was definitely the best summer party ever.